I hope the rest of your classmates keep on joining the following minutes. Until that happens, we're going to start with the class. So here we go, guys. I was telling you today we are starting the last unit. So for today, what I've prepared for you is lesson number 12A. Let's see, let's start. So the main topics or the main objectives we will be covering today are mainly how to tell a story, how you can tell a story. This story will be developed using past perfect tense. This is the last tense we're going to see this semester. Past perfect tense. We're going to learn how to use it. How is it the structure? We will see some examples and you will make some exercises as well. We will start with some animals vocabulary that we will also reinforce with some vocabulary of the book. And you will have to help me with some listening and reading exercises as well. You know that every class we have a classwork, and finally we will cover a Kahoot. That's more or less what are we going to do today as our class. So why don't we start with the animals of vocabulary? And for that we're going to play a very easy game. Very easy because I know some of you will know the answers very, very fast. Let's see what is it about. The game that we're going to play today, it's named Animals Guessing. Animals Guessing. So you know what it's going to be about, right? You're going to see a shadow on your screen, and then you're going to guess what's the animal of that shadow. Let's see, just let me, give me a second. I have to accept two of your classmates, and then we start. Okay, so let's start. On your screen, you have the game. So you're going to see like this, the shadow of the animal, and you will have to help me with the name of the animal you see on the screen, okay? So let's start. What is this animal? The animal you see on the screen, what do you think it is?
Cat.
Okay, a cat, me dicen por ahí. ¿Qué animal creen ustedes que sea de acuerdo a esta silueta?
Dog.
Okay. Dog. Some said cat, some others said dog. Let's see, what is it? Well, it's a dog. Well done. We're going to see the following animal. Can you guess what it is?
Cat.
What animal do you think it is?
Kangaroo.
A kangaroo. Let's see. Very good, it's a kangaroo. Let's see if you can guess the following animal. This is very easy. What do you think it is?
Giraffe.
That's a giraffe. There we go. Let's continue with the next animal. What? Ahora sí está facilito.
Cat.
Now we know it's a cat, right? It's a cat. Let's continue with the next. Right here. Do you know what it is?
Monkey.
Okay, a monkey. Let's see. Yes, it's a monkey. This is a dangerous animal. What do you think it is?
Snake.
It's a snake, right? A snake. Let's find out the following animal. What do you think it is? Which animal do you think it is?
Lion.
It's a lion. It has the big head and the big hair, right? It's a lion. Let's see the next one. I think it's the last one. Very, very, very easy.
Rabbit.
A rabbit. It's an animal sometimes we have as a pet, right? A rabbit. Very good. Yes, this is the last one. Do you know what it is?
Horse.
It's a horse. It's a horse. That was our last animal. So we saw different animals. Some of them were very close to humans, such as dogs, cats, rabbits, and some others were kind of a wild animals, right? Algunos eran animales salvajes. For example, the snake, we had the horse, we have the kangaroo, the lion, which seems to be very wild animals. We will be seeing a few more animals vocabulary in your textbook when we start with the reading part. Until that, I'm going to ask you something. Pay attention for the next command. You're going to see two sentences on the screen. Okay, you're going to see two sentences on the screen. Can you please, guys, help me watching these two sentences and guessing the difference? What is the difference between these two sentences? Can you find out? ¿Cuál es la diferencia entre las dos oraciones o qué ven ustedes de diferente en las dos oraciones que tienen en la pantalla?
Since
Okay, she has played. since she was in kindergarten. Y en la otra tenemos she had played soccer in the backyard before it starts to rain. What's the difference? ¿Qué podemos notar en ambas oraciones?
The time.
Okay, the time. ¿Cuál sería el tiempo, Eric? ¿En qué tiempo están estas oraciones?
Past.
Mm-hmm. Obviously, all two sentences are using past tenses. Find some different past tenses. What else can you notice? ¿Qué más tenemos por ahí? What can you see in the auxiliaries? ¿Qué podemos observar? ¿Cuál es la diferencia en los auxiliares? Can you guess?
Que después de she dice had, debería decir has en la segunda, tal vez. Maybe.
Exactly, Paul. Thank you. So in the first sentence we have the auxiliary has. Y recordemos que cuando teníamos nosotros una oración con el auxiliar has seguida de un verbo en pasado participio, nos referíamos a un present perfect. Sí, un present perfect tense. ¿Para qué nos servía o cuándo utilizábamos este present perfect? Recuerden que utilizábamos esta estructura cuando hablábamos de experiencias principalmente, de cosas que hemos hecho, ¿sí? Generalmente lo utilizamos para hablar de experiencias. So, she has played soccer since she was in kindergarten. ¿Sí? Este present perfect nos hablaba de una actividad que inició en el pasado, pero que puede repetirse en el presente o tiene su repercusión en el presente o en el futuro. Sí, ese es el present perfect tense. Y como pueden ustedes observar, está acompañado también, sí, tenemos en este caso una oración compuesta, una oración con present perfect y también por ahí tenemos un simple past. Y aquí tenemos she was, desde que ella es tuvo o estaba en el jardín, since she was in kindergarten. So, let's continue with the next. ¿Qué pasa con el siguiente auxiliar? Tenemos el auxiliar had en este caso. Had, acompañado, igual que en el ejemplo anterior, look at this, de un verbo en pasado participio. Es decir, que lo único que cambia es el tiempo en el que está el auxiliar. ¿En qué tiempo está este auxiliar? Have.
Past perfect.
Es un pasado, exacto. Por lo tanto, nos lleva a darle un nombre, ¿no? A esta estructura de tiempo, que sería el past perfect. Muy bien. Es un past perfect. Vamos a ver en qué utilizamos o cuándo utilizamos este past perfect. Miren qué tenemos aquí. Dice, she had played soccer in the backyard before it started to rain. También tenemos aquí otro verbo en pasado. Es decir que con estos tiempos, ¿no? Con el past perfect o el present perfect, podemos combinar con verbos en pasado simple. Es decir, tenemos oraciones o párrafos que van a ir estructurados con tiempos en pasado. So, the main difference between both, as I was telling you, is that with this present perfect, you start the action in the past. ¿Sí? Recuerden la diferencia. Con este present perfect, iniciábamos una acción en el pasado, pero acarrea sus consecuencias o puede volver a repetirse en el presente y en el futuro. Lo que no sucede en el past perfect. En este past perfect, la acción inicia en el pasado y termina en el pasado. ¿Sí? Antes de que otra acción inicie en el pasado. Es decir, hablamos de dos acciones que suceden en tiempo pasado. We're going to see some other examples so you can be a little bit more clear about the use of this past perfect in the next pages. Okay, so more or less, you know at least how to recognize. Ya sabemos al menos cómo reconocer cuando es un present perfect y cuando estamos ocupando un past perfect. Sí, lo que nos da, lo que nos permite a nosotros reconocer en este caso, pues, es el auxiliar. Auxiliar has or had. Let's continue with the next. You're going to see another example in the next page. Oh, this time just about this past perfect tense. Look at this. We have, she had cleaned the room when I got home yesterday. She had cleaned the room when I got home yesterday. Miren, ella había limpiado el cuarto. ¿Qué acción creen ustedes que pasó primero? Porque aquí tenemos dos oraciones y dos acciones, ¿no es cierto? Clean the room, had cleaned the room, y la otra, got home yesterday. ¿Qué acción pasó primero? ¿Qué creen ustedes? ¿Primero llegó el señor y después la chica limpió? ¿O al revés?
Al revés, teacher.
Al revés, ¿no es cierto? Aquí nos dice, she had cleaned the room. Ella había limpiado el cuarto. Es decir, que para el momento en el que él llegó, el cuarto ya estaba limpio, ¿no es cierto? When I got home yesterday. Como les decía, este past perfect tense nos va a hablar de una acción que inició en el pasado y terminó antes de que otra acción también haya iniciado en el pasado. ¿Sí? Eso es lo importante acerca de este past perfect. Let's see more about these things. As I was telling you before, this past perfect is a time that we're going to use it in order to express actions that happened before or that started in somewhere in the past. In Spanish, this specific tense will be the equivalent to the conjugation tú habías, él había, nosotros habíamos, ¿sí? A eso sería el equivalente en español, ¿sí? Why don't you help me reading the example we have on the screen? Can you please help me reading this example? Let's see who can help me reading. Yuyai, can you help me reading these two examples, please?
Okay, teacher. Why can't you get in your car? Because I had left the case inside.
Exactly. Thank you. So they say, why couldn't you get in your car? ¿Por qué no pudiste entrar en tu carro? ¿Cierto? ¿Por qué no? Because I had left the keys inside. ¿Qué es lo que pasó? Se olvidó las llaves adentro. Es una acción que inició en el pasado y pues también concluyó en el pasado. Because I hadn't left the keys inside. Let's continue with the next. Look at this. The past perfect tense is formed with the auxiliary had plus another verb in past participle. So we have another example. Ya nos dimos cuenta de cómo es la estructura básica de este past perfect, and we're going to can you help me reading, please, this time, lady? Wake up, wake up. Lady, are you there?
Teacher.
Can you help me read in the example, please?
When we reached the school, the bell had already rung. The ringing of the bell happened first.
Exactly. Thank you. When we reached the school, the bell had already rung. Cuando nosotros llegamos a la escuela, la campana ya había sonado. Sí, tenemos dos acciones. La una es llegar y la otra es que haya sonado la campana. Sí, aquí nos especifica incluso the ringing of the bell happened first. Es decir, que lo que sucedió primero fue que sonó la campana. Dejó de sonar y luego nosotros llegamos a la escuela. Tenemos dos acciones en el pasado. Here we have a little bit more specific the structure of this past perfect tense. Sí, pueden ver ustedes en la pantalla la estructura un poco más detallada de cómo se formarían las oraciones con este past perfect. Sí, en oraciones afirmativas no tenemos ningún problema, puesto que miren, solo tenemos que añadir el auxiliar had que decíamos, más el verbo en participio, right? When you are going to make some negative sentences, you will have to add the word not. Sí, vamos a añadirle la palabra not al auxiliar had. De esta forma tendríamos nosotros oraciones negativas. Ya sea que escribamos had not, o también podemos utilizar la contracción que sería hadn't. Sorry, hadn't. Yes. Plus the other verb in past participle, you know. El siguiente verbo debe estar sí o sí en pasado participio. And when you are going to ask about something in the past, using this past perfect structure, you're going to use the auxiliary had first. Y recuerden que siempre para preguntas cambiábamos el lugar. En este caso ya no iría primero el sujeto y luego el auxiliar, sino por el contrario. Primero el auxiliar, luego el sujeto, como un sándwich más o menos. Sí, primero va a ir el auxiliar, luego el sujeto y luego el verbo en pasado participio. So here we have some examples as well. Can you please, Odalis, help me reading the three examples, please?
He had there before. ¿Sigo?
Bueno, ajá.
They hadn't eaten anything yet. Had you ever done bunge jumping?
Had you ever done bungee jumping? Este bungee jumping es cuando ustedes hacen, saltan de, desde los puentes. Ese es el bungee jumping. So here we have the structure of how to make a past perfect tense sentence. In affirmative, negative, or maybe in an interrogative way. But in this case, it's not only important to know the structure or how to make it. It's also important to know when are we going to use this tense. Sí, también es importante saber cuándo ocupamos este tiempo. And look at this. Here we have some of the objectives of this tense. We're going to use this past perfect when we want to express an action that happened, that happens in the past or before another action in the past. Sí, como mencionábamos, este tiempo nos sirve para hablar del pasado, cuando algo empezó en el pasado, pero también cuando algo, ese algo pasó antes de otra acción. Sí, tenemos dos acciones. So, Alejandra Ramírez. Can you please help me reading both examples, please?
So when you go to the party, I already say I go for gotten the gift.
Mm-hmm. So when you got to the party, así que cuando llegamos o llegué a la fiesta, llegaste a la fiesta, I realized I had forgotten the gift. Es decir, que llegó a la fiesta y luego se dio cuenta que se había olvidado de llevar el regalo. Look at this. We have two actions. Tenemos dos acciones. Llegar a la fiesta y la otra, pues, haberse olvidado algo. She had forgotten the gift. Let's continue with the next use of this past perfect. We're going to use this tense when we want to express that an action happens before and a specific moment in the past. Y cuando nosotros queremos expresar que una acción inició en el pasado, pero antes de un momento específico del pasado. For example, we're going to read the next examples. Paolo, can you help me reading these examples, please?
The snow had already melted by midday.
Mm-hmm.
He had never seen the sea before the day.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Thank you. So, aquí tenemos, miren, the snow had already melted by midday. Si la nieve se derritió, ese sería el significado de melt, el verbo melt, derretir. Sí, al mediodía la nieve ya se había derretido, nos dice esta oración. Y miren la segunda. He had never seen the sea before that day. Antes de ese día, El bebé o el niño que está ahí nunca había visto el mar. Sí. Entonces tenemos acciones que ocurren con anterioridad a un momento específico en el pasado. Por ejemplo, en la primera oración, el momento específico del pasado es el mediodía. ¿Sí? Es, la nieve se derritió antes del mediodía. ¿Sí? Es un momento específico del pasado. Y en el segundo caso tenemos, he had never seen the sea before that day. Before that day ya nos especifica o nos delimita un momento específico del pasado. Él nunca había visto el mar antes de ese día. So, this is important. Let's continue with the next use of this tense. Hasta aquí, miren, ya hemos visto dos usos de este tiempo. Vamos a ver un tercer uso o cuándo o podemos ocupar este tiempo present perfect. Sorry, past perfect. Let's continue. Look at this. To talk about an action that has been repeated in different occasions until a specific time in the past. ¿Sí? Vamos a utilizar este past perfect cuando queremos hacer referencia a una acción que se repitió muchas veces en el pasado hasta un punto específico del pasado. ¿Sí? Es decir, que se repitió 2, 3, 4, 5 veces hasta un momento específico en el pasado. Let's read these examples. Vamos a leer este ejemplo que tenemos aquí. Erika, can you help me reading the example, please? Erika, are you there?
Yes, teacher, no la escuché.
Can you help me reading the example, please?
I visit the Louvre again last week. La semana pasada visité al Louvre.
Sí, el Louvre es el museo de París. El que tiene por ahí una pirámide en la parte, en la plaza. So I visited the Louvre again last week. Visité este museo, ¿no es cierto? Nuevamente la semana pasada. ¿En dónde va este past perfect? Vamos a ver la segunda oración o la segunda parte de este ejemplo. Brandon, can you help me reading the second part, please?
But you have visited in 3 times already.
Mm-hmm. Exactly, thank you. But you have visited it 3 times already. Pero ya lo habías visitado 3 veces antes. Estamos hablando de que esta acción de ir a ese museo en específico ya se repitió 3 veces en el pasado. Puede ser que tal vez él viajó en el 2000, la segunda vez en el 2004 y la tercera vez en el 2010. Let's imagine. And the last time he traveled, y la última vez que lo visitó, pues miren, fue last week, la semana anterior. Es decir, que estamos hablando de que una acción se repitió diferente número de ocasiones, diferentes veces, hasta un momento específico en el pasado. En este caso, pues ese momento es last week. So we can use it this past perfect in these cases. Look at this. We have the last use of this past perfect tense. When we want to refer to an action that started in a specific point in the past and continue until another specific time in the past when it ended. Look at this. Si vamos a utilizar este pasado perfecto cuando hablamos de una acción que empezó en un momento específico en el pasado y continúa hasta otro momento en el pasado cuando ya esta acción termina. Es decir, que inicia en el pasado y termina en el pasado. Let's see these examples. Here we have two examples to understand this point. Can you help me reading these two examples, please? Carlitos, are you there?
Yes, teacher.
Help me reading the examples, please.
Paul sold his car last month because it was old.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, he had had it for nearly 20 years.
Exactly, thank you. So Paul has sold his car last month because it was old. Este señor Paul vendió su auto porque ya estaba viejito, ¿no? Sí. Y miren lo que tenemos en la segunda oración. Dice, yes, he had had it for nearly 20 years. ¿Puede haber dos had en la misma oración? Yes, sí. Puede haber dos had en la misma oración. El primero actuaría como auxiliar y el segundo sería nuestro verbo en pasado participio. Así que esa es la razón por la que aquí tenemos doble had. Yes, he had had it for nearly 20 years. Sí, él había tenido este auto, ¿no es cierto? Por casi 20 años. Es decir, que hace 20 años, miren, Paul compró su carro, lo tuvo por 20 años y el mes pasado, que sigue siendo una acción que terminó en el pasado, pues él ya lo vendió. A eso nos referimos con el uso de este past perfect in these occasions. Pero no solo nos sirve para hablar de situaciones que iniciaron en el pasado, que se repitieron en el pasado, que sucedieron antes de un punto específico del pasado, sino también nos permite expresarnos o hablar de esta situación. Some of the most important cases, sorry, are when we want to talk about unreal or imaginary things or wishes in the past. Cuando ustedes están refiriéndose a deseos o cosas imaginarias o que no son reales, ¿sí? En el pasado vamos a utilizar este past perfect tense. For example, here we have, we wish we hadn't eaten so much. Nosotros desearíamos no haber comido tanto. Y estamos hablando de un deseo en el pasado. Y también podemos utilizarlo para cuestiones o cosas imaginarias. Something that you're going to see next class, and you will understand why are we using this past perfect tense, it's because it is very used when you are using the reported speech. Sí, cuando utilizamos nosotros el reported speech, sí, es un hecho que vamos a ocupar este past perfect tense después de los verbos como said, told, or asked, que por excelencia son conocidos como verbos que nos permiten iniciar con un reported speech. ¿Sí? Aquí miren, tenemos un ejemplo pequeñito. She said she had swum. ¿Sí? Ella dijo que había nadado. ¿Sí? Ya vamos a aprender luego todo eso de ella dijo, él dijo, él habló, yo escuché que. Y todas esas cosas. So until this point, we know that this past perfect tense is also used in reported speech and also when we want to talk about imaginary situations or things, or maybe when we want to talk about wishes in the past. Esos serían los usos principales de este past perfect. See? Look at this. Here we have a very good example. Tenemos un ejemplo triste pero cierto en esta imagen. Can you help me reading the example, please, Paola?
When I got home, my goldfish had disappeared.
When I got home, my goldfish had disappeared. Y cuando yo llegué a la casa, mi goldfish, mi pececito, mi bailarina, había desaparecido. Y miren, the lady is feeling very sad and the cat behind is very happy. Y tenemos ahí el gato que está contentísimo. Creo que ya le dio el vire al pobre pescadito, ¿no es cierto? Aquí nos dice, cuando llegué a casa, el pescadito había desaparecido. So, in this point, it's also important that the past perfect is often used with a past simple, as you have noticed. Como lo habrán notado, cuando ustedes utilizan este pasado perfecto, también va a ir de la mano o vamos a utilizar una oración por ahí en pasado simple. ¿Sí? Van como que de la mano. Tenemos una acción en pasado simple y otra acción en pasado perfecto. The two clauses are often joined with words such as when, because, or so. Para unir estas dos cláusulas, estas dos oraciones, generalmente se utiliza when, because, or so. ¿Sí? For example, here we have some examples. When I got home, my goldfish has disappeared, que es el que oíamos o leíamos primero. The next example we have, I was late because my car had broken. Sí, llegué tarde porque, ese porque nos permite unir las dos oraciones, mi carro se había averiado, se había dañado, ¿no es cierto? Miren, algo aquí muy interesante que pueden ver ustedes es el uso del apóstrofe. Hay maneras de como simplificar este tiempo verbal. La forma de simplificar el auxiliar sería utilizando un apóstrofe y una D. Miren, we have never been to a concert before. We've never been to a concert before. Esta contracción que utilizamos del auxiliar, el apóstrofe y la D, se utiliza principalmente para hablar muy rápido. To speak very fast or maybe when you are listening to songs. Cuando escuchan canciones también van a encontrarse mucho con este apóstrofe D. Mucho ojo que puede a veces confundirse con la contracción de would. Sí, que también es apóstrofe D. Mucho ojo al verbo que tienen al lado. Si está en pasado participio, pues seguramente hablaremos de un past perfect. That would be the case of the past perfect tense. Let's see something else, guys. Vamos a ver lo siguiente. We're going to cover some exercises as well. Here we have some exercises about past perfect tense. I'm going to ask some of you to help me completing this exercise, okay? Marco, can you help me with the first one, please? ¿Cómo nos quedaría la primera?
The first. The first, the rule by the time funeral. Had already?
Already, ¿qué más?
No sé qué más.
Tenemos ahí el otro verbo. Justo en el paréntesis al lado de already.
Had already reached.
Exactly. Had already reached. Algo que no les había comentado, pero que seguramente tal vez tienen una duda, es si es que cambia el auxiliar con he, she, it. Este auxiliar had va con todos los sujetos, desde I hasta they. Con todos los vamos a ocupar el mismo auxiliar. ¿Sí? No se olviden que el verbo que tengan ustedes va a ir en pasado participio. En este caso, reached o alcanzar, que sería el significado en español, pues es el verbo que vamos a conjugar en pasado participio. The fire had already reached the roof by the time the firemen arrived. El fuego había llegado ya al techo, a la terraza, cuando los bomberos llegaron. Let's continue with the second example. We have the verb on parentheses. Tenemos los verbos en paréntesis para poder conjugar. Can you help me with this second example, please? Verónica, can you help me with the second sentence, please?
Yes, Joel Smith went to prison because he stole a lot of money.
Okay, because he had. ¿Cuál será el pasado participio del verbo steal? Robar. Es un verbo regular. Ok, Yuya me dice stole. Stole sería el pasado simple. Vamos al pasado participio.
Stolen.
Stolen, very good. Stolen. So Joe Smith went to prison because he had stolen a lot of money. Sí, este señor Joe Smith fue a la cárcel porque había robado mucho dinero. He has stolen a lot of money. Number three, please, can you help me with the sentence? Diana. ¿Cómo nos quedaría el número tres?
Helen went to bed after she had watched her favorite TV program.
Exactly. So she had her favorite TV program. Exactly. Let's continue with number four. Can you please help me with number four, Fabricio? My father.
My father bought the new car after had tried.
Exactly. After he had tried. A few times. Sí, él compró el carro después de haber intentado hacerlo algunas veces. Thank you. Let's continue with number five. Can you help me, Paul? By the time.
¿Cuál, los cinco, dijo teacher?
Yes, number five.
Had the room.
¿Cómo nos quedaría toda la oración?
By the time Sonia got to the party, everyone had begun to sing.
Exactly.
Dancing.
Dancing. Everyone had begun. And the last one, we have Lorenzo. Can you help me with this one, please, Paolo? ¿Cómo nos quedaría la número 6, Paolo?
Lorenzo had eaten.
Exactly. ¿Qué más? ¿Qué más sigue por ahí? Ahí está.
Lorenzo had eaten all the ice cream before I opened the fridge.
Exactly. Lorenzo had eaten all the ice cream before I opened the fridge. Lorenzo se había comido todo el helado antes de que yo abra el refrigerador. Exactly, guys. Perfect. You did an awesome job completing these sentences. Now it's time for you to help me with another exercise. Vamos a hacer otro. These answers, and then we'll move to the following exercise. What are we going to do? You're going to see a video, and then you're going to answer some questions about the video, okay? Van a ver un video y luego me van a conversar qué fue lo que pasó en el video. ¿Sí? ¿Qué situaciones ocurrieron? You're going to see these two guys talking. Vamos a ver de qué hablan estos chicos. Ok, just let me share the video with you. Here it is. Pay attention to the video, guys. Vamos a prestar un poquito de atención con el video. Pay attention. It's a very nice and funny story.
How was your date last night, Jake?
It turned out okay, but I had some problems along the way.
Why? What happened?
It started when I was getting ready to meet Anne. After I had brushed my teeth, I used some mouthwash to make sure my breath would be extra fresh. At first, I was fine, though it was a strong taste. But the taste got more intense as I rinsed my teeth, and my mouth felt like it was on fire. Then I looked at the bottle I had used. I realized I had rinsed my mouth with aftershave instead of mouthwash. The mouthwash and aftershave bottles were right next to each other. I quickly rinsed my mouth and used the mouthwash from the right bottle this time.
You must have been pretty distracted to make that kind of mistake. Did everything else go okay?
So, until this point, what happened with this guy? ¿Qué pasó con el chico ahí? What happened with him? What happened when he was brushing his teeth? ¿Qué pasó cuando estaba lavándose los dientes?
Confusing.
Can you repeat, Yuyai, please?
He had confused.
He had confused. Very good. He had confused. What did he use? Look, here you have the answer. Instead of using the mouthwash, ¿sí? En lugar de utilizar el enjuague bucal, he used his aftershave bottle. ¿Sí? Utilizó la loción o el tónico para después de afeitarse en lugar de lavarse con el enjuague bucal. Imagine that. That's why he said, I felt that my mouth was on fire. Sentí que mi boca estaba en llamas, le dice al amigo. So, have you ever got confused that way? ¿Alguna vez se han confundido de esa manera? Not with the same, but with another thing can be. Let's find out the next part of this conversation. Vamos a ver qué pasó después.
Did to make that kind of mistake. Did everything else go okay?
Unfortunately, no. I went to get dressed and realized I had left my best shirt in the washer. I had meant to put it in the dryer before I started getting ready. I went to get it from the washer, but my mother had already put it in the dryer. I was relieved until I took it out. The shirt had shrunk.
This is important. The shirt had shrunk. What do you think is the meaning of this verb? ¿Qué significará el verbo shrunk? Shrunk. Cuando algo se encoge o se hace más pequeñito, vamos a utilizar este verbo shrunk. So, what happened this time? ¿Qué le pasó a este chico esta vez? Eric, what happened with this guy? What happened? Look at this. You're going to watch it again and you're going to tell me what happened.
I went to get dressed and realized I had left my best shirt in the washer. I had meant to put it in the dryer before I started getting ready. I went to get it from the washer, but my mother had already put it in the dryer. I was relieved until I took it out. The shirt had shrunk.
Oh no. Did you find something else to wear?
I was running short on time, so I threw on a different shirt and ran out the door.
What happened with this guy? ¿Qué le pasó? Cuando estaba buscando qué vestir, ¿qué le pasó? What happened with this guy? Have you heard that sometimes when you dry the clothes in machines, they used to get shrunk? ¿Sí? Cuando ustedes generalmente utilizan la máquina para secar la ropa, ¿sí? Luego de utilizar la lavadora, le ponen a la secadora, pues la cierta ropa tiende a encogerse o a hacerse más pequeña. ¿No les ha pasado que a veces ustedes utilizan un pantalón, una chompa o medias y después de lavarles y secarles a veces se hacen pequeñitas? ¿Sí? That's the case of these guys. That's exactly what happened to him. Let's continue seeing the next part of the story.
I got to the restaurant in the nick of time. I sat at a table to wait for Anne to arrive. After I had waited for a few minutes, I realized I had put my shirt on inside out.
This is a nice expression. Do you know what's the meaning of inside out? ¿Tienen idea o sabe alguien qué significa esta frase, inside out?
Adentro.
Adentro hacia afuera.
Exacto, un significado que nosotros lo conocemos en español como al revés. ¿Sí? Cuando ustedes vean este inside out, se refiere cuando nosotros utilizamos, por ejemplo, la ropa al revés, está puesto lo de adentro afuera. ¿Sí? I had realized, miren, tenemos aquí la oración en pasado simple, I had realized. Yo me había dado cuenta que me había puesto, yo me di cuenta que me había puesto la camisa al revés. ¿Sí? I realized I have put my shirt on inside out. Del apuro que tenía este chico, miren qué le pasó. Se puso la ropa al revés. Let's continue with the next.
Out. This had never happened to me before last night. I went to the bathroom to fix it. When I came back, a waiter had given my table to someone else. I told a server what had happened, but he said I would have to wait for another table. After about 10 minutes, I told them that I had waited long enough. They finally gave me a new table, apologizing that they had made a mistake.
Did Anne show up?
No. I began to get frustrated. No.
Did Anne show up?
That was a good phrase also. Do you know what's the meaning of show up? Llegar, aparecer sería, ¿no es cierto? Este show up. En este caso estamos hablando de que si alguien llegó a una cita, ¿no es cierto? Did Anne show up? ¿Llegó Annie a la cita? Esa es la pregunta que tenemos aquí. Did Anne show up? Let's see if she showed or not showed up. Let's see. Veamos si llegó o no llegó la chica.
No, I began to get frustrated. I had been sitting at the table for about 15 minutes when Anne called me. She sounded upset. She said that she had waited for me for over 20 minutes. She had left the restaurant and was in her car, about to go home.
How come you never saw her?
I asked her where she had sat at Taqueria Loca, and she sounded surprised. She had been at Taqueria San Jose. Since I already had a table, I told her to come to Taqueria Loca.
Then Anne made it to the restaurant, right?
Yes, she did. After 10 minutes had passed, Anne finally showed up. When I saw her, I felt the wait had been worth it. We stayed at the restaurant for a long time, eating and talking.
Did you have much in common?
Yes, we did. It turns out she had listened to most of the same music I did when I was a teenager. She had even played on a basketball team, just like me.
Great minds think alike. I'm glad the rest of the night went smoothly.
Look at this, you have another new phrase right here. This is very popular. Great minds think alike. ¿Han escuchado ustedes esta frase en español? Great minds think alike. Ya sea como broma o que lo hayan escuchado en algún lugar, generalmente en español nosotros tenemos la frase las grandes mentes piensan igual, ¿verdad? Las grandes mentes piensan igual. Ese sería el significado de este great minds think alike. Let's continue with the next part of the video.
The rest of the night went smoothly.
Not exactly.
Oh no, did something else go wrong?
After we had eaten, I went to the men's room. When I looked at myself in the mirror, I saw that I had several large pieces of cilantro in my teeth. They had been there the whole time I was talking to her. I was so embarrassed.
That's not a big deal. People get stuff in their teeth all the time.
Yeah, but that's not all. I made the biggest mistake of the night when we were in the parking lot. She leaned towards me and I thought she wanted me to kiss her. I leaned in to kiss her and hit her head really hard. She told me that my car keys had started to slip out of my jacket pocket, so she had only meant to reach for them.
That is bad. How embarrassing. On the bright side, at least you got to meet her. Are you going to see her again?
Yes, tonight. Oh, that reminds me, I have to go. I had bought a new shirt and I left it at the dry cleaners. I better go get it.
I hope you have better luck tonight.
Thanks.
Past perfect. The formula for past perfect is had plus past participle or the third form of the verb. We use the past perfect to express a past action finished before another action in the past.
When I came back, a waiter had given my table to someone else. I asked her where she had sat at Taqueria Loca. After 10 minutes had passed, Anne finally showed up. I went to get the shirt from the washer, but my mother had already put it in the dryer. I had meant to put it in the dryer before I started getting ready.
We also use the past perfect to show that something happened before a specific time in the past.
This had never happened to me before last night.
So guys, you saw a little bit of the video. It was a very nice and fun story, right? We saw a guy going to a date and all the things that can go wrong happen to him. Todo lo que puede salir mal, parece que le salió mal a este chico en su cita. So, that was also a very short explanation of the tense we saw, which was past perfect. And for now, we're going to match these pictures. We're going to match the pictures we have right here with the animals. Remember that I told you we were going to talk about the animals? Well, here we have a story about jumbos. So just let me open the book so we can see all the animals and we can match the animals with the pictures. Do you know the names of these animals? What is number one? What animal is number one?
Bee.
Mm-hmm. This is a bee. This is a bee, right? Una abejita. Number two, do you know what's the name of number two? ¿Cómo nos referimos al número dos? We can say that number one was a bee, right? What about number two?
Mosquito.
Exactly, it's a mosquito. It's a mosquito. So we have number two right here. Number three, what is it? It's very scary, number three.
Spider.
Mm-hmm. It's a spider, a big brown spider. And what about number four?
Parrot.
Mm-hmm. It's a parrot, very good. It's a very colorful parrot. Oops, mosquito is number two, not number three. I got it wrong. And then we have the parrot, which would be number four, thank you. So let's move to number five. What is it? What is number five?
Gorilla.
It's a gorilla. It's a gorilla. Thank you. What about number six? Let me move so you can help me with number six. What is number six?
Camel.
Mm-hmm. It's a camel. Number seven, what would it be? Todos tenemos una cobija en la casa con un animal como el number seven.
Tiger.
A tiger, very good. Todos tienen en casa la cobija de tigre, ¿no es cierto? A tiger. And the last one we have right there, what would it be? La ballena, ¿cómo diríamos ballena? We have the camel, number six, number seven, the tiger, and what's the name of the last one? Ballena.
Whale.
Whale, exactly. Whale, the biggest animal on earth. The whale. Very good. So, at home, now that you're at home, and nobody else can listen to you, and you can be honest and practice, I'm going to play a record, and you're going to say aloud these the pronunciation of these animals, okay? So you will have time to practice these animals' names at home. Let me play you the record.
Track 3.49. 1. B. 2. Mosquito. 3. Spider. 4. Parrot. 5. Gorilla. 6. Camel. 7. Tiger. 8. Whale.
Okay, we got all the answers right. Logramos unir muy bien todas las imágenes. And now we're going to start with a reading. Here you have a story. It says Jumbo's story. We are going to see who Jumbles is. Vamos a ver quién es Jumbo. And then you will help me completing or answering some questions. Luego vamos a completar y a responder un par de preguntas. Can you help me reading the first part, please, Steven? The first part.
Okay, teacher. Jumbo's history. In 1986, a video of frightening event involving a gorilla and a boy was watched by millions of people around the world. The video, which is still popular in the internet today, changed people's opinions gorillas forever.
Exactly. Thank you, Stephen. So in 1986, a video of a frightening event involving a gorilla and a boy was watched by millions of people around the world. The video, which is still popular on the internet today, changed people's opinions about of gorillas forever. ¿Cuál será el video o qué fue lo que pasó en el video? Vamos a ver en esta historia. Aquí nos dice un video aterrorizante, ¿no es cierto? A frightening event, un evento aterrorizante. Sucedió con un gorila y con un niño. Vamos a ver qué pasó. So, can you please help me reading number one? Number one, help me reading Marco, please. Number one.
Number one, on 31 August of 100, sorry, no recuerdo cómo leer los números.
De dos en dos.
1986, a couple took their two young sons to Jersey Shore. When the family arrived, they went to see the gorillas straight away. The father noticed that the children were too small to see the animals, so he picked up his five-year-old son, Levan, and put him on top of enclosure wall. Then he turned around to pick up his other son.
Okay.
La pregunta es, what do you think next?
What do you think happened next? Y esta pregunta le vamos a hacer a todos sus compañeros. ¿Qué creen que pasó después? Look at this. A couple, una pareja. Ese sería el significado de esta palabra, couple, pareja. A couple took their two young sons, to the Jersey Zoo. Sí, esta pareja y sus dos hijos fueron al zoológico de Jersey. When the family arrived, they went to see the gorillas straight away. Esta es una frase también que van a utilizar o van a escuchar bastante. Straight away significa que fueron de inmediato, que fueron directamente hacia algo en específico. En este caso, puedes ir directamente hacia los gorillas. They went to see the gorillas straight away. So, the father of the children, the father noticed that the children were too small to see the animals. So, he picked up his five-year-old son, Levan, and put him at the top of the enclosure. Es decir, que apenas llegaron ya a la sección de los gorilas, el papá pues se da cuenta que sus hijos son muy pequeñitos y no pueden observar muy bien. Entonces toma a su hijo de 5 años, ¿sí? Y le pone en la parte de arriba, es decir, en el cerco de la división con los animales. Cuando él regresa a subirle al otro hijo, ¿qué creen que pasó? What do you think happened next? What do you think happened next, Eric? ¿Qué pasaría después? ¿Qué creen que pasó después? What do you think it happens next in the story? Yuyai, can you help me? What do you think it happens next?
I don't know.
No idea. Paolo, what do you think it happens next?
Jumbo fight with the child.
Okay, the gorilla fight with the child. That's a good option. Another option. Can someone tell me what do you think happened next?
Sí está bien dicho, el gorila le pegó al niño.
¿Cómo diríamos en inglés? The gorilla.
The gorilla. Fight, por eso le dije fight.
Fight sería pelear. Si quieres decirle como que le pegó, sería hit. Hit the kid podría ser. El gorila le pegó al niño. That could be an option. Have you ever been next to monkeys or gorillas? Anytime. ¿Alguna vez han estado cerca de los monos o de los gorilas? Inesu. En el zoológico de Guayabamba, ¿no? Have you ever visited a zoo?
No, I don't like the zoo.
You don't like the zoo. Why, Paolo?
Maltrato animal.
Okay, they mistreat the animals. Okay.
¿Cómo dijo? They mistreat the animals.
Mistreat
the animals.
They mistreat the animals. Okay, that's a good reason. But yes, some of these animals used to be very stressed, and that's why they act very in a violent way. Están muy estresados algunos animales y actúan de forma violenta. Let's see what happens next. Vamos a seguir leyendo para ver si encontramos qué fue lo que pasó. ¿Cuál es la historia de este video que dicen que fue tan popular en internet y que cambió la imagen de los gorilas? Let's see what happens. Let's move to number two, part of the reading. Vamos a leer la parte dos de la lectura. Just let me move. Okay, let me move to number two. Let's read point number two. Can you please help me reading this part, Paola?
Some people had always thought that gorillas were dangerous animals. But the video changed their means. Journalists named Jumbo the gentle gigant, and stones, letters, cards, and even boxes of bananas arrived for him at the zoo. Jumbo did it in 1992, but a statue at the zoo remains the word of this wonderful animal.
Exactly. Thank you. So, aquí nos dice that Jumbo dice, people had always thought that gorillas were dangerous animals. La gente siempre ha pensado que los gorilas son peligrosos, ¿no es cierto? Dangerous. But the video changed their minds. Pero el video cambió sus mentes, dice. Journalists named Jumbo, the gentle giant. Sí, le nombraron como un gigante bondadoso o amable. Jumbo, el gigante amable. Sí, and soon letters and boxes of bananas arrived to the zoo. Luego le enviaba, miren, la gente, después de ver el video, le enviaba a Jumbo cajas con bananas. They say that this gorilla died in 1992. Murió en el 92, pero se creó una estatua en su honor. Dice, a statue at the zoo reminds the world of this wonderful animal. Sí. Let's continue with number three. Vamos a ver qué pasó con la historia, ¿no es cierto? Estábamos quedados en qué pasó con la historia. Recordemos que el papá había subido a su hijo a la parte de arriba del cerco, ¿sí? Y se dio la vuelta para coger a su otro hijo. Vamos a ver qué pasó mientras él se dio la vuelta. Can you please help me reading number three, Brandon?
When the father turned back, leaving had disappeared. The boy had fallen off the wall in the gorilla area. The shocked parents looked down and saw that their son was lying on the ground, about 4 meters below them. He wasn't moving.
Okay. La pregunta es,
what do you think the father did next?
What do you think, Brandon? ¿Qué crees que hizo el papá después de eso? Look at this. When the father turned back, cuando el papá se dio la vuelta, turned back, cuando se dio la vuelta, Levan had disappeared. El hijo, es decir, Levan, desapareció. The boy had fallen off the wall. El niño se cayó de la pared into the gorilla area. Se cayó a la parte de los gorilas. The shocked parents, ¿sí? Los padres que estaban en shock, looked down and saw that their son was lying on the ground. ¿Sí? Miraron hacia abajo y vieron que su hijo estaba tendido en el piso. He was lying on the ground, about 4 meters below them, and he wasn't moving. Y el niño no se estaba moviendo. What do you think the parents did next? ¿Qué creen que hicieron los papás? Alejandra, what do you think the father did next?
I don't know, teacher. He got scared.
Okay, maybe he could try to get the kid back. Okay, let's see what happens. Vamos a ver. Para saber qué fue lo que hizo el papá, nos vamos a ir to number five. Vamos a irnos a la número cinco. And number five, can you help me reading number five, please, lady?
Levan's father tried to climb down into the enclosure to rescue the boy, but he was stopped by the other zoo visitors. Slowly, the gorillas come closer to Levan. A large crowd of people had come to see what was happening. Everyone was screaming and shouting.
They were scared that the gorillas might seriously hurt the boy. Jumbo, a 200-mile gorilla, go to Levan first. What do you think Jumbo did?
Exactly. Thank you. Aquí miren, ya tenemos la respuesta. ¿Qué fue lo que hizo el papá? He tried to climb down. Sí, él intentó pues subir o llegar hasta la parte superior de la división, ¿no? De la jaula y poder ir a rescatar a su hijo. Ojo, que aquí le dice, but he was stopped by other sub visitors. Fue detenido, he was stopped, por otros visitantes del zoológico. Slowly, the gorillas came closer to Levan. Es decir, que lentamente ya los gorilas se dan cuenta que el niño está ahí y se van acercando. A large crowd of people, ¿sí? Una gran multitud de gente se acercó a ver qué estaba sucediendo. Everyone was screaming and shouting. Todo el mundo gritaba y chillaba, ¿no es cierto? They were scared that the gorillas hurt seriously, may seriously hurt the boy. Todos con miedo de que los gorilas pues le vayan a comer al niño, le vayan a pegar, le vayan qué sé yo hacer, ¿qué no es cierto? The first gorilla who appeared was Jumbo. So, can you imagine or can you tell me what do you think Jumbo did? ¿Qué creen que hizo Jumbo? Steven, what do you think Jumbo did?
Jumbo sleep at the children.
Okay, se durmió junto al niño. Slept by the children. Okay, that could be an option. Let's see what happened. Let's see what happened with Jumbo's and the boy. Con todos los deseos de seguir durmiendo que tiene. Steven también dice que el gorila se durmió al lado del bebé. Vamos a ver qué pasó. So, help me reading number 4, please. Paul, can you help me reading number 4?
Number 4?
Mm-hmm.
Did the Jumbo move it?
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Ponerme los lentes.
Le hago más grandecito también.
Yeah, there. Jumbo moved carefully around Steven. He softly stroked his back. Then he sat down between Levan and other gorillas. When he saw that young gorilla had come too close, Jumbo stood up and did not let him pass. His message to the gorillas was clear: don't touch him. Jumbo pulled gently at Levan's clothes and offer while leaving, opening his eyes and started to cry.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. So Jumbo moved carefully about Levan. Acordémonos que el gorila Jumbo fue el primero en acercarse al niño. Look at this. He moved carefully around. Sí, se movió muy cuidadosamente alrededor de este niño Levan. And he softly stroked. Esta es una palabra nueva, stroke. Stroke puede significar acariciar. Sí, en este caso, he softly stroked his back. Él cuidadosamente o delicadamente acarició su espalda. Then he sat down between Levin and the other gorillas. Se sentó, sí, entre el niño y los demás gorilas. And when he saw that the young gorilla had come too close, sí, cuando Jumbo ve que ya otros gorilas empiezan a acercarse al niño, he stood up and did not let him pass. Sí, él se levanta y no le deja pasar al otro gorila que se estaba acercando. His message to the other gorilla was clear. El mensaje que le estaba enviando, ¿no es cierto?, era muy claro. Don't touch him. No toquen al niño. Jumbo pulled gently at Levin's clothes, and after a while, Levin opened his eyes and started crying. Sí, luego, pues el niño abre los ojos y se da cuenta que está cerca de los gorilas y empieza a llorar. What do you think Jumbo did when Levin started crying? ¿Qué creen que hizo el gorila cuando escuchó al niño llorar? What do you think? Oh, Dalis, what do you think Jumbo did when the kid started crying? Odalis, hello, are you there? Can you help me answering this question? Mahu, what do you think that happened with the kid?
He's throwing the back.
Okay.
Yeah.
What else?
Oh, don't touch him.
Okay, he was defending the kid. So he didn't want that anyone else touch this kid. Okay, that's a good answer. Thank you. Let's continue and let's find out what happened with Jumbo and this small kid in the last part of the reading. Vamos a ver qué pasó en la última parte de la lectura. So, number 6. Can you help me reading, please? Diana. Number 6. Can you read it, please?
Number 6. Jumbo ran away and his gorilla family followed Jim. Sometime later, zookeepers rescued Levin from the enclosure. He had broken several bones in the fall and had seriously hurt his head, but he was alive. A man had filmed everything and millions of people around the world watched the video on the news. The zookeepers become heroes and so did.
Mm-hmm. So Jumbo ran away. ¿Sí? El gorila Jumbo corrió. ¿Sí? And his gorilla family followed him. Y todos los demás gorilas de su familia lo siguieron. Sometime later, zookeepers rescued Levan from the enclosure. Luego nos dice algunos cuidadores del zoológico, zookeepers, rescataron a este niño pues de la valla, del cerramiento donde estaban los gorilas. He had broken several bones, se había roto algunos huesos en la caída, in the fall, and has seriously hurt his head. Sí, y se había pues lastimado también la cabeza. But he was alive. Pero todavía seguía vivo el niño. A man filmed everything and millions of people around the world watched the video on the news. Sí, es decir que siempre hay alguien por ahí filmando, ¿no es cierto? Lo que sucede y pues la gente pudo ver este video en las noticias. Nos dice, the zookeepers became heroes and so did Jumbo. Sí, ellos se volvieron héroes al igual también que Jumbo, que le había protegido al bebé o al niño de que, los demás gorilas le lastimaran. So, that's the story about Jumbo, the gorilla. Thank you guys for helping me reading and to the ones who helped me also answering the questions. So, why do you think, can you help me with these questions, the last questions I'm going to make you? Why do you think Jumbo protect the boy? Paolo, why do you think Jumbo protect the boy? ¿Por qué crees que el gorila protegió al niño? Why do you think Jumbo protect the boy? Yoyai?
Because he has paternal feelings.
Okay. He has paternal feelings. That's a good answer. Maybe he saw the boy scared and crying also. And he thought he could protect the boy, right? Thank you guys. So, what are we going to do next? We're going to start with your classwork. For today, you have a very easy classwork if you paid attention to the past perfect tense. We're going to complete a worksheet, and you know how to do it because we have been working in this, the second part of the semester. And once you open the link I'm going to share with you, you're going to find the following page. Y una vez que ustedes también ya completen, abran más bien dicho el link que les voy a compartir, se van a... se van a encontrar con la siguiente link. You have the link right on your Zoom chat. Ya tienen el link en el chat de Zoom para que puedan abrirlo. Se les va a abrir esta página que ven ustedes en la pantalla. What are you going to do? You're going to complete the sentences. Van a completar las oraciones con los, pues con cualquiera de las opciones que tienen, los recuadros que tienen en la parte de abajo según corresponda. Sí, vamos leyendo y vamos uniendo. That would be part one. In part number two, ¿se acuerdan que les dije que cuando utilizábamos este past perfect, utilizábamos dos oraciones, ¿no es cierto? Una acción que pasó primero y otra acción que pasó después. Eso es lo que vamos a elegir en este ejercicio. Tenemos, look at the sentences and choose which happened first. Vamos a elegir cuál de las acciones inició primero y cuál fue después. Okay, so read the sentence. By the time Charles arrived at the office, the boss has already left for the meeting. Leemos la oración y luego escogemos qué evento ocurrió primero. That would be part number two. And part number three, you have to choose the right option. Y vamos a ir completando las oraciones en forma correcta, seleccionando la opción correcta. Then once you finish, you know that you have to send the answers to the following mail. Les envío ya el mail con al que deben enviar las respuestas. Y en este momento les creo la actividad para que puedan subir su imagen una vez que hayan terminado y enviado las respuestas. Do you have any questions, guys? ¿Alguna duda o alguna pregunta? It's not so long. We just have to answer 8 questions. 8 preguntas debemos responder nada más. Keep on joining to the Kahoot. You have the code on your screen, guys. Okay, we are 10. Vamos ya, 10. Sigamos uniéndonos al Kahoot, chicos. 8 preguntas. 8 preguntas sobre el past perfect tense. ¿Cómo nos quedaría el past perfect? Exactly. She had been. Recuerden que el verbo después del auxiliar have va en pasado participio. En este caso sería Suri had been working until 9 p.m. Very good. Let's continue with question number 4. Complete with the past perfect. Vamos a utilizar el past perfect con el verbo stop. Mika and Yin go into the library after construction began. ¿Cómo nos quedaría? ¿Cómo diríamos Mika and Yin habían dejado de ir a la librería? Had stopped. Don't forget, no se olviden. Had, el auxiliar en pasado, y stop en pasado participio. Very good. Had stopped going. Let's continue with number 5. To make the past perfect tense, which word would you add? ¿Sí? Cuando hacemos una oración negativa, ¿qué palabra añadimos? To make past perfect tense negative. ¿Qué añadimos? Not, never, no, or none. Not, that's right. The right word was not. Have not, right? Let's continue with the next. Congratulations. Identify the past perfect. She had not remembered to visit her grandma before going to Canada. ¿Qué es lo que nos quiere decir esta oración? In past perfect. That she had not remembered, right? En esa parte nosotros nos podemos dar cuenta que ahí está el pasado perfecto, en had not remembered. Very good. Let's continue to question number 7. complete with the negative past perfect. ¿Cómo haríamos negativa esta oración? Ashley con el verbo noun. ¿Cómo nos quedaría negativa? Time's up. 3, 2, 1. Yes. Had not known. Cuando queremos hacer una oración negativa, recuerden que podíamos añadir luego del auxiliar had, pues la partícula not, o podíamos ocupar la contracción, ¿verdad? Hadn't. Cualquiera de los dos nos iba bien para una oración negativa. Let's continue with the final question. Complete with past perfect. ¿Cómo nos quedaría esta oración en past perfect? We, the movie until the power went out. We had enjoyed. Very good. We had enjoyed. Let's see today's podium. Congratulations, Carlitos. You got the third place. Well done. Diana, congratulations too. And the first place goes to Odalis. Well done. Congratulations. Congratulations for today's scores. Thank you guys for participating in this Kahoot. Now, let me share with you what you have as a homework. You will have a homework for next class. What do you have to do? You have to listen. You're going to make a listening homework. This time, you will have also to open a link and work in a live worksheet. And you're going to make a listening exercise. Remember that this time we were talking a little bit more about the animals, right? We were talking about animals in this unit. And part of your homework, it's going to be to listen to a record about some animals. Once you open the link, una vez que ustedes abran el link de del homework, se van a encontrar con esta página. Listen and fill the gaps. Ustedes van a encontrarse con algunos espacios vacíos, espacios largos. ¿Qué significa? Que ustedes van a ir escuchando, le van a dar play al record y van a escuchar a alguien leyendo este artículo. Ustedes van a ir completando los espacios que tienen en azulito, ¿sí? En blanco. So, for example, let's see. Where you are going to put or play the record. Pueden ponerle play al audio que tienen justo en la parte superior.
Lesson 6F. Real animals that were once a myth. 1. Giant squid.
In ancient Greek times, there were stories about huge sea monsters with very long arms.
Vamos a ir completando de acuerdo a lo que vamos escuchando en el audio. So, this would be your homework. You have until tomorrow midnight. Y tenemos hasta el día de mañana, medianoche, para completarlo. No está complicado. And in this way, you'll learn about some animals that once were a myth, okay?